What's up, peers, and welcome to the reading of the BISC Decentralized Exchange White Paper, Phase Zero, A Plan for Bootstrapping the BISC DAO. Today, continuing with Appendix A, Roles. The following are roles that individuals play when using BISC or otherwise participating in the BISC DAO. One individual may play any number of these roles, with the exception of bonded contributor roles, where no individual may play more than three. Trader. A trader is anyone who uses BISC to exchange with others. Trades have no specific role to play during phase zero, other than contributing to the BISC as per usual. When phase zero is complete, traders will be able to buy BSQ token and spend them on BISC trading fees at a discount rate. Contributor. A contributor is any individual who works to improve BISC. Contributors submit their work as pull requests to appropriate repositories in the BISC network GitHub organization. Contributors may additionally submit compensation requests to be paid for their contributions in BSQ. Stakeholder. A stakeholder is any individual who possesses BSQ. Because BSQ cannot be bought or sold during phase zero, the only way to become a stakeholder during phase zeros are A, to be a past contributor included in the testnet BSQ Genesis distribution, or B, to contribute new work, issue compensation requests for it, and be paid in BSQ. That is, the only way to become a stakeholder is during phase zero is to earn it. Founder. A founder is one of the individuals responsible for establishing the BISC project and or designing the BISC DAO. BISC's founders are Manfred Karrer and Chris Beams. A goal of phase zero is to distribute responsibility away from the founder role into smaller, better defined roles played by a large number of bonded contributors. Bonded contributor roles. This section has been superseded by the roles document. Maintainer and operations and operator and administrator as well. Appendix B, resources. GitHub, the BISC network organization. The repository is the BISC network GitHub organizations are where changes to BISC software and documentation are integrated and staged for release. The only contributors who have write access to these repositories are their respective maintainers. Work on bug fixes, features, and other improvements is done in contributors' personal forks of these repositories, and changes are then submitted via pull request. Our approach to collaborating is based closely upon the C4 process. Issues labeled BSQ Bounty. Compensation Repository. The Roles Repository. See also the Roles documents for full details. The Proposal Repository and the Docs Repository. Spreadsheets. BSQ Stake and Vote Tracking Spreadsheet. BSQ stake and vote tracking is in this Google Sheet. Other, Slack. Feel free to discuss the BISC DAO, BSQ token, and phase zero plan in the DAO channel of the BISC Slack workspace. BSQ transaction explorer. Testnet BSQ transactions can be explored in this explorer. Appendix C, use cases. What follows are various actions or use cases each BISC DAO user role can engage in during phase zero. This section is a work in progress. Use cases have been called out so far as we have identified them, and specific instructions will be filled in as they become clear. As a contributor, I can search for open bounties. The following GitHub issues search query will display all open issues in the BISC network organization with the label BSQ bounty. Contributors can browse the list to find open bounties they are interested in working on. Note that the list is currently empty. See the defined bounty issue above. Signal my intent to work on a bounty. Once you have found a bounty issued you would like to work on, it's a good idea to let others know what you are planning to work on. 1. Add a comment to the bounty issue letting others know you plan to work on it. 2. If you have questions about the nature of the work, ask. Use GitHub issue comments to take the conversation to Slack, the mailing list, or any other medium you prefer. You can work on a bounty. 1. Fork the repository in question. 2. Create a topic branch from master specific to the bounty in question. 3. Work in that topic branch until complete. 4. Submit a pull request from your topic branch to the master branch of the upstream BISC network repository. See the next section. And then submit a pull request. Pull requests must be well formed. Follow the guidelines in the contributions file. Submit a compensation request. To submit a compensation request, create a new issue in the BISC network compensation repository and include the following information in the issue description. The amount you request in BSQ, the address that BSQ should be paid to, see below for instructions how to generate a BSQ address, links to the issue, pull request, and any other work you want to be compensated for. Comments that help explain what the work is, why it is valuable, etc. See BSQ network compensation number 2 for an example compensation request. How do I generate a BSQ address? Open your BSQ client. Press Ctrl-D on macOS or Ctrl-D on Windows or Linux, and you'll see the DAO button appear in the top menu. Click it, and you'll be taken to the screen with your BSQ wallet. Copy your BSQ address and use it in your compensation request. Once submitted, your request will be added to the voting spreadsheet, where stakeholders can vote on it. You can submit a proposal. See here how to submit a proposal. As a stakeholder, I can put a proposal to a vote. During phase 0, we do now not formally vote on any proposal other than the compensation request. Generic proposal voting will come online with the first production software release of the BISC DAO, for example, or that is when we exit phase 0. Vote on a compensation request. 1. Open the BSQ stake and vote tracking spreadsheet. 2. Request editing permission, if you have not done so already. 3. Find the row for your BSQ address. And 4. On that row, select -1, 0, or 1 in the vote column for each compensation request, where -1 means you are voting no on this compensation request, 0 means you are abstracting from voting in this compensation request, and 1 means you are voting yes on the compensation request. It is important to vote no if you believe the request should not be approved. Keep in mind that compensation requests can always be adjusted and submitted again in the next round of voting. You can fulfill any vacant bonded contribution role. Request to take over an occupied contributor role. As a founder, you can define bounded contributor roles and initiate bound amounts. Issue monthly BSQ Genesis distribution on Bitcoin testnet. issue the final VSQ Genesis distribution on Bitcoin mainnet, and modify this plan. Post phase zero use cases. As a stakeholder, I can sell BSQ on the BISC exchange. As a trader, I can buy BSQ on the BISC exchange. And as a trader, I can spend BSQ on discount BISC trading fees. Other use cases not listed here. Each specific contributor roles not listed here, for example, GitHub administrator or Twitter account operator, defines use cases specific to that role. See the BISC network role repository for details. And peers, this has been the phase zero, a plan for bootstrapping the BISC DAO, showing how the BISC decentralized exchange will continue in its quest of becoming private, censorship resistant, and decentralized. Piers, thank you very much for joining, and thank you very much for listening to me. And see you on the next show. Bye-bye.